First of all, you don't want to play two players in the same line. Because if you play two players in the same line, when the ball is on the wing, this will give the opportunity to one defender in the zone to play two players. So for example, ball is there on the wing. Don't want to play two players on the same line here. Because this player, defend the ball, because this player can disturb two players at the same time. So we will either play, seal him, okay, and ask to get the ball, okay, and you play here, stop, and you play there. Just moving the players away from the straight line, we have already created a problem to the defense. Or we do the opposite. So you play the elbow and you come to the ball. That's it. Okay? It's clear enough? You never play two players on the same line when the ball is on the wing. Second, high post and big post. High post and low post. If you have, or if you want to play a medium post here, this player needs to space differently. Must maintain distance with the medium post. Because if he wants to play high post together with the low post, here, go there. Okay. Now you can play the other side. Play the other side. One hand here and disturb the other player. Like this. Look. Okay. Just like this. Okay? And you here, you disturb two players. Okay? We don't want them to play too close because otherwise this player can disturb two players. So if you want this one medium, because he's a player who can be dangerous in the post, because you want him to catch the ball in the post, you need to space this player differently. And the bigger the team is, the less you can make this mistake. Now, if for other reason you want to have a player in the high post, because he's a shooter from 2 point, because he's able to put the ball here on the floor and break the defense, now you need to play with the low post, not... So they must maintain this distance between the two players, okay? They cannot play close one to the other. If you want the high post on the foul line, you will drop down the second line of the defense. If you want to spread that player out, you can move up the line of the defense because you play medium. But that's something that you have to make clear to the players. And you have to make clear to yourself. Depending which kind of team you have, what kind of big men you have, where they are more effective, you need to take a decision. And last, throw the ball to the other side. Let's say you play baseline. There. Or even here, but stay there. Okay, play there, medium, play on the wing. Give him the ball. Stay in the middle. Okay, set up the zone, very good. Okay. When you play the weak side, okay, you must try, unless you have a player in the corner, okay, you need to play foul line extended, one step below the foul line extended, because on the ball reversal, you want this baseline player to come out on you for a second so that you have the pass, you have the drive, you have the shot, you have everything. If you play too high above the foul line extended, if you play here, okay, now you see you become too close. Even if he stays in the middle, now it's easier for the two guards, for the two defensive guards to cover you. Come on, it's a 2-3, come on, okay. And this player will just fake and stay back. So you want to create a situation where one defensive player needs to commit one-on-one. And if you stay on the weak side, below the foul line extended, here, on the ball reverse, can we play the, can the zone play with the ball there, please? Okay, move up, move up, move up. Hey, okay, here. Okay, if he comes this low with the guard, now we have space up there, you see? If they come, again, if they come out, no, 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 stay there, stay there. If they come out with a baseline player, for a second, but now we have space on the baseline. You want them to commit with one of the two players. And that's why you need to get the right spacing on the court. Right spacing is a matter of the relationship between big and big, if you play with two bigs. It's a matter of the three perimeter players. It's a matter of perimeter and high post. Perimeter and low post. Very, very important, because if not, I go back to what I said at the beginning. You let the offense, I'm sorry, you let the defense play with one defender, two offensive players. And that's what you don't want. This is as for the spacing. Now, dribble. Just get baseline, get baseline. It's very important that we teach our players how to use the dribble against the zone defense. Two, three very important things, at least to me. First of all, if the defense is in a stationary situation, so he's not moving already, he's not, let's say, recovering, he's not running, but you're coming, boom, 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 and you want to start using the dribble in this situation, you need to attack one player. You need to dribble at one player. See what happens if you do this. If you do this, what you're going to do defensively? You leave him open or not?
I leave him open.
You leave him open, just shoot? Okay, no. Probably you move a little, correct? Okay, okay, come here. Come here. So I attack him, okay? What you do? You probably slide a little bit, you slide a little bit, you slide a little bit. Okay, so we are creating already a very, very simple situation, which is a little bit more man-to-man. Because just to give you an idea, let's say you have a good player there in the on the block. Let's say you can play the post-up. You can play with your back to the basket. Okay, zone, we're playing zone. Okay, I just attack one man. Okay, if I attack one man, instantly they do this, throw the ball inside. Inside! Quickly. Tip, tip. If I attack the middle, if I attack between the two players, what probably will happen is that that player will play a little, okay, that's it, now over, over, we are in two, three, open. Exactly. Like this, probably you will play like this, no? Looking this and this one, correct? You will protect the middle, you will play two against one, and we are exactly what I said I don't want to see offensively. If I do this, okay, they're still gambling, and maybe you can... Exactly, and it's a totally different story. Totally different story. As an example, now we are matched up against their five, against their big men. Before, we were attacking the wingman, which supposedly is not as big as the player in the middle. So I insist, I want to attack, if the defense is standing and not moving, I want to attack one man and make him play me and see how they move the defense. Okay? One. Ready? Look, 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 look. How do you play if I come here attacking this man? How do you play? Like this? Just screen him, screen him, screen him, screen, no, screen him. If he plays like this, keep him inside, get to the corner, come on, shoot him. Come on. That's it. So we agree we can do that. So you probably do something else, correct? What can be the second option if I attack him? If I attack him, what can be the second option? You play like this, very good. If you see he's going out to get on him, now, prepare yourself. Go put your body on the five men. You understand what I mean? If you see this, go put your body, okay. Come here. Okay, come on. So you have to read what he's doing. If you, when you see, go back. When you see that I am attacking my man here, and he stays over you, just go screen him and put your body on him, but deeply, get inside. And now see what we have. 1, 2, 3, if not, boom, and you can just post him. Okay, very good. If you see that he stays inside you when I'm attacking him, just, and you go from there, you can have a shot or a dribble penetration. Okay, very good. Different is when the zone is moving. And when the zone is moving, it will happen, stay a little bit more in the middle. We have two players on the baseline. Stay a little bit more in the middle. There is no high post. Okay. Move the ball. Now, in this case, they are coming out. Okay? Maybe most zone will do one step and back, correct, until you come here. So when you see the defense coming at you, what I would like you to do is to drive between the two defenders. You understand what I mean? Okay? The same for you. If from here the ball comes to you and you see the defense coming to you, I would like you to break the two defenders. Exactly. When you see that they are moving, I would like you to break. When you see that they are standing, I would like you to attack one defender. Okay? Let's try from the beginning here so they can see. They are standing, okay? So just go ahead and play. You don't have it. Okay, that's it. One more time. You had the ball, first pass. They are coming out, yes or no? They came out. Break the two defenders. Don't dribble on the spot. Okay, one more time. Attack one defender. Okay, stop, one more time. If you dribble there and they match up there, why don't you swing the ball to the other side? You're big, you can see the whole floor, just use it. This is good for you. Come on. That's it. Bring it. One more time. Look, this is a big point against the zone. Now we had a good action of handball. You play the whole action behind the three-point line, and then you shoot a three. What we would like to do is that we shoot the three after the ball goes inside, or with the pass, or with the dribble. When you force them to do this, and then ball goes out, shoot every time. But until we move behind the three-point line and they don't close, don't shoot. Okay? Force them, try to break the defense. That's it. Break two players. That's it. Hola. Again. Break the two players. When the ball is coming to you, do the same thing. Go there. Tap. Okay, stop. Pass the ball to him. Now, if you don't pass the ball and he's coming out, wait for them, and when they try to do this in the middle. You understand? So now you have the pass there or the pass there. And you have two players against you. You understand what I mean? Come on. That's it. Come on. When I have two players on me, somebody's open. It's true or not? Come on, we don't move from here until we don't do it well. That's it. Good. Switch offense and defense. Stop. Do the same thing. You attack this man. You go lower. And what you did, you went there. Stop. Where are we? Oh, okay. Because there we have more space. Now we attack two on two on the other side. And you can post or you can get the corner. Just to create space for us to drive. Okay? Let's see. Well. Okay. 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 Hey. We're putting together the concept, eh? We're not putting inside the play. So here in this moment I'm just focusing the way the three players play to penetrate and pass. I'm not concentrating in anything more. This is not a set play, this is not an organized play. I just want them to pick up the idea that if they dribble in one specific position, they have something on the other side. And if the defense is running at them, they have to break the defense. Okay? Hey, defensively, we don't want to give up a set three, huh? Come on, come on. Yes, 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 between the two, between the two, excellent. Between the two, excellent. Good, 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 good. Score. And one. Good. Excellent. Okay. Stop. Third thing about the dribble. And it's easier for me to show it attacking a 3-2 zone. Set, put up in a 3-2 zone. You are the point. You are the wing. You are the wing. You are the two big men. Okay? Because our players must keep in mind that many times we have offenses against the zone and we start the offense overloading one side of the offense with the dribble. And there are defenses that when we move the ball to the side, they follow you with the player who is defending you. For example, if we are attacking a 3-2 zone, play a little bit wider. Okay. And if I move to the side, some zone defense, some 3-2 zone, matchup, they match up like this. Point comes with me, and if the player goes, you do this, pa pa pa. Okay? Some other zones, still with concept of aggressiveness, play different. When you see me dribbling to the side, you jump on me. You move, you protect, you drop down. Protect, protect. No, no, not you. Point, side on the high post. It is clear? Okay? Very good. So do it again. So if I dribble, all right, they just come up. Okay, that's it. Perfect. You can see both of them. The concept is when you play offense against the zone and you dribble the ball, okay, whatever position, if you dribble against the zone and your man comes with you, throw the ball back. Because that's where you will find spacing and advantage. So if he moves here, right, throw the ball there, so you're gonna be spaced well there. Okay? Just for an example. Now when I do this, get the corner, and you go to follow the ball. Do you understand what I mean? And get in the corner and be dangerous. Okay. No, no, no. Okay, ready, zone, we see the zone, ready, good. Spread the offense, spread the offense, that's it, play! Attack! Or go make a screen and attack, understand? Come on, play! Go, 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 space it, space it! Boom! Head up, stop, head up, head up, head up! One more time, one more time, one more time! Hey, cut where you open! Come on. See what the defense does. See what the defense does. That's it. Stop. Stop. We're not playing man-to-man. We're playing zone defense. All right? We're talking about zone defense. So stay in a zone, please. Okay? Thank you. Come on. Bravo. Okay. Cut. Cut. Good spacing. Good spacing. Good spacing. That's it. Good. Good. Very good. One more time. One more time. Very good. Good. My focus is in creating spacing for my players. This is what I'm focused in this moment. I'm not focused in giving them an organized set play. Because if they don't know how to get the proper spacing and the proper timing against the zone, whatever organized offense I will run, they will run it like this. And I don't want this. Okay? So I'm taking time in my practice, especially in the preseason, for them to learn the concept. This is why I have not said anything organized yet. Okay? I'm just telling them to focus, to put the ball and the players in a position where they can have space to attack. And I want them to understand what they have in front. Okay? It is clear? And you two have not flashed one time yet to the high post. So see. Okay? Now different. I dribble the ball. And you're not followed by the player which is with you, but they come with you with another player. So I would like you to pass the ball ahead. Okay? And then defense will react and we will play from that. Okay? So he's dribbling. Come on, go. He sees the switch. That's it. Stop. If you see, flash. Come on, one more time. One more time. See the defense. Good. Good. Stop. Fuck. That's it. Do the same thing. Stop. Hey. Can you get the ball right there? See it? Look. It's easier for him to give you the ball if you stay here or if you just do this and show yourself here like this. What do you think? Yeah. Okay, good. Now, you know even why? Because do you see what happened to this player? He was flashing here. So if you see this, just move on the baseline. So he can shoot or can give you the ball there for a dunk. Exactly. Okay? If he comes here and you are here doing this, the two of them can play together. But if you see that he's staying there, where you should flash? A little bit higher, correct? Maintain distance between you two, okay? Let's go. Good. Come on. Bravo. Stop. Somebody needs to shoot. Huh? Switch. Switch offense and defense. Switch offense and defense. Come on. Let's go. Okay. Stop. Come on. See what they do. Hey, now follow him. Follow him, okay, on the dribble. Hey, we are 3-2. 3-2. Come on. Come on, follow him. Exactly. Switch. Good. Excellent. Play here. Medium. Okay. Very good. Medium post. Create situation of 1-3-1. You already have seen this offense. Ball, especially against 2-3 zone. Play a 2-3 zone. Very good. Ball to the corner. Cut. Come baseline. And you move up a little. Just there. Okay, bravo. Okay. Come here. Okay. Now, wait. You dribble out, and you have this triangle. If not, you reverse the ball to the point. Boom, reverse, and both you two cut. Okay, this is a very common offense against the zone. Do it again. Do it again. Especially teams that play with four players on the perimeter, because they have a good shooter at the fourth position, they play like this. They play a 1-3-1 offense, they overload the corner, throw the ball, cut, okay? And now, on the dribble, we need to see how to read this situation. And this is exactly what I was just teaching them before. Do it again. I am the corner player, okay? Play medium, and when the ball goes to the medium, maybe even lower if you want, and when the ball comes to me to the corner, you just move up a little bit, okay? Come on, play the offense. Okay, here. Okay, stop. Now. You're on me, okay? If I dribble out and you come with me, okay, what we said before, if you are followed by the player that you have in front when you dribble, okay, pass the ball back, because that's where we have advantage. And now you cut and dunk it. That's it. Boom! If you do this, come on, again, stop, now, if you come, go ahead, if you see that he's coming to you, okay, move a little bit, and now you pass the ball there, now you run, and we cover everything, okay, and we lose him, okay, on the other end, if they switch when you dribble, okay? If they switch, because they don't want to move this player far out. So you dribble, and they come with the guard. Now pass the ball ahead, because now look, that's where we are, 2-1. You see? It is clear to everybody. It's another situation where you are dribbling against the zone, and if you are followed by the player you have in front, you need to pass the ball behind you. If you are dribbling the ball and they switch, pass the ball ahead so you beat the rotation of the zone. Okay? So let's run this situation. Okay? And hey, the two defenders here, 1 and 2, communicate to tell them to decide who will follow the ball. Okay? Is it clear? Let's go. Okay, cut it. Hey! Oh! Excellent! Very good! Okay. One more time. Hey, to the side. Other side. Stop. Where is open space for you? When you cut and they move the ball, where do you have open space? And so why you stay there? One more time. Stop. I would like one more time to point out that I'm not teaching yet one organized play. Because for me it's much more important that they learn how to recognize the spacing against the zone, and how to use the dribbling and the movement without the ball in the right way. If they don't learn this, whatever offense you run, it will be bad execution. So I prefer to spend few practices, especially in preseason, to teach them this, starting from the concept, okay, rather than giving them the offense and telling them this is the offense. The most important thing is that, as for the defense, to learn to see and react, on offense is even more important, that they start to understand on the court what happens if they do something and what happens if they do something else. Remember what I said at the beginning, timing in zone offense is different, because you need to give the time to the defense to to commit themselves in a position. Get the ball here. Okay, dribble the ball. What did you do? You follow him, correct? Very good. Follow him. Stop. Stop. You see that he's following him? Yes or no? Okay, so how can he give you the ball if you run like this? Tell me. So when you make the pass, okay, you can cut like this or like you did. But you just look. Because if you cut, get back. Get back. If you cut, we're playing 2-3, no? Correct? You're here. If you cut and you see that he's going with him, you must offer immediately a pass. And you, what you do now? What do you do? Come on, inside. Here, nothing, boom, three. Nothing, baseline. Ball? Yes, but, my friend, if you catch the ball here like this, can you do something? So and so. If you catch the ball like this, can you do something? Okay, so please focus. Huh? Come on. Ready? And you must wait and see until they are clearly on you. So, come here. Okay, ready slowly. So wait, make him stay here. Make him stay here. Boom, then give him the ball. Don't be so anxious to throw the ball away. One more time, come on. Come on. Good, good, cut! Come on, come on! Good, one more time. You have to, if you catch the ball here, on the baseline, like this, it's very difficult. If you are playing the baseline, play with your back to the sideline. So from here, you can even catch and see everything, and you can still attack. Okay, now, ball in the corner, ball is dribbled out, now we switch. Hey, it is clear? When the ball is dribbled out, we switch. 2-3, can I see a 2-3? A 2-3 zone. Can I see a 2-3 zone? Very good. Come on. Excellent. Excellent. Switch. Switch offense and defense. Come on, create the triangle, create. Okay. Switch. Swing, swing. Here it is. Boom. Foul, excellent. One more time. Good. Good. Swing it, swing it, swing it. Switch. Now. So we talked about spacing, we talked about dribbling, and we talked about positioning. Now, one thing we need to use more is ball fake, because defense react on the fake of the pass, okay? So for example, every time you dribble to one side of the floor, if you want to use more the defense, you fake. If you fake the pass, hope probably you will make a step, you can have this, and then you can move. Okay, this clear? So just, now, you dribble to one of the side, okay, and after you dribble to the side, corner player, if you don't receive it, you move on the baseline. You understand? And you two, now, you will play trying to get position. You will have a shooter running the baseline, and you will try to play to post up your man. It is clear? Okay? Where, which side you decide? Why?
Because there's other defender from high.
Okay, that's a good point. Or there is another thing that can help you to decide which side you will start. What can you look at?
Maybe my best big man is on the side. and I go to this side. Or I can take my shooters on the other side.
Bravo, exactly. You see? Very good. Come on, let's go. Hey, move up, move up! Stop, stop, stop. We are playing three against three. You're playing only the three perimeter players and the two inside players are almost lost. We need to connect the three outside with the two inside. Okay? Hey, if you see he's coming away, you bring a guard here. Come on, let's go. Come on. Up, up, up. Good. Spacing. Good. Good. Switch. We need to play the three outside and the two inside. And you're playing just by themselves. Come on. Concept, concept, concept. Stop. I said start with the dribble and then we move the player on the baseline. Come on, just listen. Come on, come on. Well, move up, move up. I said, let's start with the dribble to the side, and if the corner player does not receive the ball, we'll overload the opposite corner. One more time. Come on. Go, go, go. You see? That's it. That's it. Again, again, the same, the same. It was very simple and very good. Come on. Come on. Nice, one more time. Remember, if you want to get him open, the center, you come here. Come here. Follow me. Okay? If you fake him, you see, now you have more spacing. If you don't fake, look, stay, stay. If you don't fake, you have little bit of space. You see? Because he's defending too. If you fake him, most of the time he makes one step, and now you have more space for him. Okay? Come on. Same thing for you. Do the same thing. Tap, 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 tap. Come on. Dribble. Dribble. Come on. Overload. 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 Stop. Okay. This is great. This is great. Now throw the ball back to me. Okay? Because I want to show him the same thing on the other side. Do it again. 2-3. Yeah? Just playing 2-3. Don't worry. Okay. Oh. Fuck me. 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 He. Ich.
Okay.
Ich bin Trainer. Okay. Okay. If you play defense like this, that's probably sexual harassment, but not defense. Huh? Okay? So let's play defense. We have other time for sex. Come on. Okay. Obviously, if he does not come out, he's completely open. But if you see that he's fighting him on top, do it again. Try not to leave the shooter open in the corner. You got my point? Okay. Slowly. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. One more time. Okay. Oh, okay. Is this clear now? Again. Okay. You see? That's where you can get it. Okay? And if you are in doubt and you see that he's preparing to get out, you just fake it. You give yourself the time to open the defense and put the ball inside. Okay? So just simple on both sides. Okay? Come on. Come on, let's go. Okay. Great pass. Great pass. Great pass. Very good. Excellent, excellent. Good. Get the corner. Switch. He's completely open inside. And if we throw the ball inside, maybe he might not even shoot immediately, but just wait, collapse the defense, throw the ball out, we have a good shot. Huh? Come on, come on, come on. Switch, switch. Great pass. Good. If you see this, okay, ball is going to the other side, okay, and you see we are creating this situation. If you stay there, do you agree that your man is disturbing your teammate? So why don't you come here immediately? And if he gets the ball, maybe you can cut. If he helps you dunk, if not, we have the shooter on the other side. Yep. Let's try it. Good, good, nice play. The timing is excellent. Look, the action, which is extremely simple, because they are just taking advantage of the 2-3 zone that on the dribble, every man on the zone is taking at least one man. But you understand that if he starts the cut too early, will bring the zone against him. If he cut too low or too late, he will never get the ball. So the key is to start the cut after the zone has committed to the corner. And then line, he's cutting and they had a great time. Now I would like to say a couple of things about screening. And I go back to what we said before, screening against the zone. Screening against the zone usually comes when you have a shooter overloading the corner, like we are doing now. We have a shooter running to the corner and we have a big screening the zone. Exactly. Now, we don't want to get caught in an foul. So we give a very simple instruction to this player. If the defender is coming at you, you just screen him and hold. That's it. That's it. But if he's making any kind of effort to go by you, front or baseline, we don't care. You can go now. No. Exactly. That's the point. Don't post him. Don't post him. Let him go because this is an offensive foul. You just want, the zone is moving. So can we do it slowly, please? Can we do it slowly? And I show. Go back from there. Okay. Let's start with the ball there. Let's start with the ball there. Make a pass and start cutting. Okay. Slowly. So we see. Slowly. 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 Okay. Start moving. So you see this. He stays, okay, we're going to get open somehow. But if you see he's going and this player is coming to you, come to him and post him here inside. So you try to get this meet instead of trying to make an offensive foul. Referee is here, and if you reverse pivot, or you spin off a defender, he'll call the foul. So you just walk inside the zone, okay, you just go to his chest here to the middle, okay, and then you reverse pivot and you try to get open, okay? And this is another moment where you see this and you see what the defense is doing, and if you see your teammate, I'm sorry, your this defender just fighting with your teammate, you have the shooter open. If you see that he's going behind the screener, fake him so you will throw the ball inside, okay? Now it's up to you, you decide how to defend, okay? Start, start. Okay, ready? Come on. Hop. Okay, we overload the corner. Oh. One more time. Great, nice move. It was open. Come on. That's it. Very good and simple technique. Okay, let's do it the other side now. Throw with him, fake pass, boom, pass ball and overload the corner. That's it. You see? That's exactly right. Bravo. Very simple. Simple like that. In these situations when we set screens, okay? Same thing here on the side. For example, come up with the big. Okay, very good. Okay, I dribble. Okay, he stays. I will go. You can have shot. Okay, but if he see that he's fighting you, yeah. Just let him go and go get the second player. Okay, we are defending the zone. We are ready. Okay, ready. Fighting. Fine. Go get the second. Now seal him to get the ball and score. You understand what I mean? Moving to you. Okay. So come on. Yeah. Or I. Okay. Okay. That's it. Why you play the two of them so close? Where could be smart for you to go when I dribble there? Huh? No, he's screening me. Look. Give me the ball. You see what we're doing? We're screening the ball. And they are fighting. So you know that if they are fighting, he's going to screen the second defender. Okay? Bravo. Look at this now. The ball goes there. Look. 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 Look what you have in the corner. Okay? Look what you have inside. If you shoot, your friend will rebound. And if you close inside, look what you have in the corner. That's it. Okay? It's very simple. The concept is, if you screen a man against the zone, and the man fight the screen, let him go, and go get the second and reverse pivot on him. This is on every position, on any position of zone offense. Can be on the high post, can be on the baseline. Don't waste a chance with an offensive foul. If defense wants to go under, over, whatever, just let him go. Let him go. Make the defense commit on you with another defender. So somebody else will be open. So now very simple. Very simple. Look. If I make first pass here, now fight. If he a ball to me, okay, come screaming. No, come up and screaming. Okay. Very good. Very good. And then you read. Okay, maybe you can roll there, maybe whatever, blah, blah, blah. Okay, if I start here, you come screen. Okay, and we work the situation. Work the situation. Okay, 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 okay. Russell, you are in the middle of the balls. You got to anticipate. You know that he's going there, so you need to clear that situation. You understand what I mean? Because you're going to be open there. When your big is screening here, come like a snake on the baseline, boom, we'll give you the ball. Just go behind the defense. Come on. Come on. Yes, 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 yes. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Look behind sometimes. Watch behind because...
Okay.
Look at that. Was very good. One more time, one more time. Movement of the two bigs was excellent. 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 Okay, 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 okay. That's it. That's it. Hey, because both of you are posting too much. I mean, both of you are doing much better, but you go low, you're still playing with your back to the basket. You can play with your back to the basket, especially against the zone defense, until you are medium. Because now, from here, you can go here, and you can go here. But if you are on baseline, and you continue to play here, you have no space to go. You see where you are. So when you understand that you are baseline, just instinctively, come like this. And now you see how you can see everything. Come here for a second. You see that you see all the game?
Yes.
And still, you can still get it, face, shoot, make a dribble, dunk, whatever.
Yeah.
Okay? And you see the help coming. What I said to him, it's extremely important to build our offense, and especially when we are coaching young players, to teach them or to help them to understand from young age where the help is coming, is I think a major part of teaching the offense. We teach the fundamentals, the dribble, the pass, the shooting, the one-on-one. Now, when we put together the old things, the five players movement, to have an idea of where the help is coming from is very important. If not, you will see young players that get the ball, go here, and they are surprised that somebody is there, and they either walk or make an offensive foul. So they need to understand that if they go some way, they'll probably find help somewhere. If they go somewhere else, they'll probably find different kind of help. To know where the help is coming from helps you to anticipate your decision, to understand where you will pass the ball and to whom you will pass the ball. So that's a big key. Put yourself in condition that you can know where the help is coming from. We're in a 2-3, I insist, not a 3-2. We are on a 2-3. Come up, 2-3 zone. 2-3 zone. Okay? 2-3. Oh, okay, that's it. Now, again, boom, boom. Now, you two anticipate the action. If you see that we're starting here, come up a little earlier. If you see we're going there, come up a little earlier. Come on, was very good. Come on. Come on. Come on. Here we are. That's it. Excellent. No kidding. Ah! We make a fantastic play and you miss the layup. Now we go back for two times to the other action when we overload with the dribble. Okay? So now, if you make the... Okay, let's do this. Now you start again with the dribble. Okay? Pop, 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 pop. And when we scream, flash, high post, blah, blah, blah. Okay? Let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on. Excellent. One more time. Come on. Come on. Hey, remember. Hey, we screen. We screen. And if the defense is fighting, we post the second player. Come this side. Come this side. This side. This side. Okay. 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 Stop. Fake the corner. Fake the corner so the defense will go to the corner. Switch. 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 Okay, bravo, weak side, run, run! Another quote by Krešimir Ćosić. A three-point shot makes nice an awful play. Most of the times. We were awful for 20 seconds and then we hit a three-point shot and everything looks good. One more time. Come on. Stop. He's open in the corner. So make him touch the ball. It does not mean that he will shoot. At least make him touch the ball. He's open and he just hit a shot. True or not? So try to see the whole picture. He just scored a three-point shot, okay? Go there. So now, if you make him touch the ball, what the defense will do? That he might score second time. And if he scores second time, coach will get crazy. So, put on his hands. So they will come to play defense, and now you will throw the ball back and run to the other side. And run to the other side, screen and fight. Boom. Hey, hey. Where you have big opening? Ah, okay. Wunderbar. Come on. Come on. Come on, let's go. Good. Fuck. Bravo. Switch. Switch. Come on, come on. One more time. Hey, the two big men, when you are on the opposite side and you see an opening in the middle, you need at least to be ready to do this. If you stay on the other side like this, we play 5 against 4, okay? Now with the pass, what we do if we pass the ball? Hey, what we do if we start with the first pass? What we do? Pass, and then when the ball goes back, what we do? Come on, exactly. What you do? What you do? Huh? Huh? So please, do it. Come on, ready? Go. From the beginning. And go put your body on the next defender if he fights through the screen. Come on, let's go. Bravo, excellent. Excellent. That's it. Stop. One more time. Excellent play and excellent pass. Bravo. Bravo. Come on, come on. Come on. Come on. Okay. Here we are. Here we are. And that's it. And that's it. Very good. Very good. One more time. Get the corner. Get the corner. Because if he's screening the ball, he must need the space to pop out. You understand what I mean? Okay? Now. Now. One more time. That's it. Great spacing, great timing, and very good passing. Bravi. 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 Excellent. Excellent. Now. Now we go, we are attacking a 2-3 zone and we go 1-3-1. Okay? Come up on the post. Here, 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 here. Remember what we said at the beginning? Not play on the same line. Okay? So when the ball is on the wing, okay, you move and you step to the ball. A little bit in the middle. Okay. Try to get it. Boom. Okay. And we just move. You move baseline, you follow, no, 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 he follows the ball. And you play here, together with me, okay? And we just add one thing. If your defense is playing between the ball and you, you screen every time. You know what I mean? So, if the ball is there, and they defend him, and they defend him, aggressively, okay? You play to receive a pass, because you see how we are with the shooters. Okay, you try to get open, now you move the ball with the pass. Exactly, exactly. But if they play halfway, if they play halfway, eh, play half, that's it. Okay, now you screen him and you break the defense. Okay, it is clear? And you what you can do in that situation. Bravissimo. Okay, come on, let's go. Very good. Very good, the ceiling of the guard. This is very important, bravo. Excellent. Excellent. Okay, 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 okay. One more time. Wide defense, wide offense, wide offense, wide offense. Black ball, come on. Come on. No, 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 no. You see, ball is going there, okay? Stop. Who has more advantage in cutting? Who has more advantage in cutting? Him? Why? Don't you think stay there? Stay, hold the position there. Cut. Cut. Okay. Stop. Stop. Even stop there. Even stop. Stop there for a second. Come here. Look at the spacing we have now. And look this. Come back. Give him the ball. Give him the ball. And with the ball flying, cut, cut. No, no. Not when the ball is already there. When the ball, when he's catching the ball, in the move. Okay? So if he comes, if the guard comes with you, he has a completely open shot. Okay? Or if you don't have it, it's because he's open. So keep in mind, when the ball goes to the low post, if you are low, you try to come high to show yourself. If you are high, you cut low to cut. Or go to the rebound. Okay? Come on. Bravo, 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 bravo. Cut, cut! You see? You see? Corner, corner. Excellent. Excellent. Bravo. Bravi, vai. Good shot. One more time. One more time. Trip. That's it. Hey, we are losing both of you because you're playing back to the basket on the baseline. Even now, you had a good cut. And how did you stop there? Do you see? How? You had a good ball went to the inside. You cut, you finished the cut here, and with the ball movement, you were posting here on the baseline. So you take away the penetration and you take yourself away from it. Play like this. Okay, so he can give you the ball, or if he drives the middle. Okay, this is the major reason why we are losing you. The major reason when you attack a zone, why at one point you feel that the three outside are play without sync with the two inside players, is because usually the two big men are posting too much, instead of using those middle corner position that spread the defense. And if you start losing sync between the three perimeter players and the two big men, it becomes very difficult to attack the zone. So you need to post a little bit less when you are on the baseline. Post medium, okay? Not baseline. Okay, let's go. One more. Great pass. Very good action. Very good action. Bravo. One more time. That's it, that's it. Stop. Stop. What happened? This is another big point of teaching offense. Because we always say that we need to teach players to be unselfish. Okay, we surely want this. We, all of you, would like to have players who are unselfish. But I really believe that it's not exactly like this. Because the key to have good offense is to understand when you must be unselfish and when you must be selfish. Meaning that in some situation of the offense, you have to play aggressively for yourself to receive the ball and score, because otherwise you put the offense in trouble. Because we become too much passers and nobody will score. This was a good example of what I mean now. Do the same thing. Do the same thing. The pass was there, no? So now he was driving, okay? Now, you know that probably the ball will finish here or here. So this is a great moment to put the body on him, move the ball there. Just do this and it's a layup. To play a little bit more yourself. What you did was probably, correct me if I am wrong, I had the feel that you wanted to give space to them to penetrate. And what you did was on the penetration, just cleared, okay? Which is good because you give space, but we become much stronger if you, with all this space, you just see your man and finish. Okay? So one more time. That's it. That's it. Excellent. This, by the way, will happen because if you seal the man, still they have the penetration, so they have the penetration. Okay? Very good. I would like you to give a big hand because the second part, they were excellent. And the offense became to flourish. Thank you. Thank you so much.